The World Health Organization warns the COVID-19 pandemic is far from over. Debates have erupted on whether the virus is becoming endemic after studies showed severe Omicron is less severe compared to other variants. But the WHO asserts Omicron is not risk-free. It points out the high number of infections across the world means many people are still falling seriously ill and dying.
Omicron continues to sweep the world. Last week, there were more than 18 million reported cases. The number of deaths remains stable for the moment, but we're concerned about the impact Omicron is having on already exhausted health workers and overburdened health systems. In some countries, cases seem to have peaked, which gives hope that the worst of this latest wave is done with, but no country is out of the woods yet.
The Philippines detects nearly 500 additional cases of the Omicron variant. Out of 714 sequence samples, 492 were carrying the highly transmissible variant. This raises the total number of confirmed Omicron cases in the country to 535. Of the new cases, 332 were local and 160 were returning overseas Filipinos. Most of the local cases are from Metro Manila. Three cases are still active, while two have died. Most of the patients have recovered. The Philippine COVID-19 Task Force says testing backlogs are expected to be resolved within the week. COVID-19 Task Force Deputy Chief Implementer Vince Dizon says those being tested are now getting their results faster compared to early this year when the surge began. Many patients who were exposed to the virus had to wait for at least 3 days to know their status.
Nung mga nakaraang linggo, umabot ng 3-4 na araw ang paglabas ng resulta. Ngayon, isa't kalahating araw na lang lumalabas na on average at minsan sa loob ng 24 hours. Kaya ngayon, mapapansin po natin, pataas na ng pataas ang ating testing output. Umabot na tayo ng mahigit o 8 a day at tataas pa yan in the coming days.
A vaccine expert says getting infected with COVID after being fully vaccinated gives what she calls a natural boosting response. Dr. Nina Gloriani, chairperson of the National Vaccine Expert Panel, says those who recovered from severe COVID receive a higher level of immunity. But she adds antibody tests is only recommended for immunocompromised individuals.
Hindi na natin nire-recommenda yung malawakang antibody testing, no? Actually, ang aming rekomendasyon para lang sa moderately to severely immunocompromised, pwedeng mag-request ang mga doktor nila ng antibody levels nitong mga immunocompromised. Pero sa general population, hindi na po.
The Department of Education in Central Visayas suspends classes in several cities due to rising COVID-19 cases. The so-called health break will be implemented in Cebu City, Talisay City, Carcar City, and Baez City in Negros Oriental. DepEd Central Visayas said three teachers and five school personnel in the region have so far contracted the virus. The suspension also comes after the health department confirmed 22 cases of the Omicron variant in the region. The rise in COVID cases in Cebu City also evident in hospitals. Dr. Maria Chua of the Perpetual Socor Hospital says they're currently tending to 200 coronavirus patients, most of which are mild cases. Over a dozen of their doctors and nurses have gotten sick as well.
Yun ang nakakatakot kasi kahit na meron tayong capacity,
yes,
I mean bed-wise, pag wala na yung manpower, doon kami mahihirapan.
The Philippine Transportation Department clarifies not all workers are exempted from the no vaccination and no ride policy in Metro Manila. That's a day after Labor Secretary Silvestre Bellu III announced the policy is not applicable to workers.
hindi rin lahat pwedeng lumabas ng workers. If only if your industry is allowed under alert level 3, will you be allowed to board public transportation. They will really have to present a proof that they are workers.
Secretary Bello, meanwhile, assures the riding public exempting some workers from the no vaccination, no ride policy is safe.
Our workers, when they are unvaccinated and for them to report to office, they have to undergo PCR. The reason why safe sila kasi magpa-PCR yan, lalabas na negative. Otherwise, hindi sila tatanggapin sa trabaho. So let's assume that everybody is acting in good faith.
The DOTR also says they are studying the possibility of putting up vaccination sites at terminals and expressways. A pharmaceutical group welcomes government's move to tap drugstores and clinics as vaccination sites for booster shots. The Pharmaceutical and Healthcare Association of the Philippines says the group has been advocating for some time now to let pharmacists be involved in the vaccine rollout. He adds pharmacies have the right equipment to store vaccines.
Pharmacists are highly trained. They've been going through courses particularly geared at vaccination, how to handle vaccines, what to watch out for when they administer the vaccine to the recipients, and the potential side effects. It's important to select the proper venue, right? Because not every single drugstore will be an effective vaccination site. And remember, this is just in addition to the current vaccination centers. So it is not a total shift from the current vaccination centers to the pharmacies. So this actually expands capacity of the government to be able to administer vaccines. With the proper setup, I think with the selection of the right store, with appropriate space, etc., I'm pretty sure they'll be able to handle this particular program.
On Tuesday, the Philippine government announced several pharmacies and clinics across Metro Manila will be allowed to administer booster shots beginning January 21st. The program will then be expanded to other parts of the country.